check 1 2 1 2. Check 1 2.
If I have to adjust it, okay, we already all right. You ready?
Sure.
Okay. Laura, are you gonna stay down there or come up here?
I feel very elitist up here.
So my name is Casey Turner, and I put on concerts all over the Bay Area, and this one worked out so great because I live like 4 blocks away. So first of all, guys, thank you so much for having Megan and us here. So for those of you that, it's pretty obvious, there's this thing going around the world that is just shut everything down, and one of the first things that got nipped was live music. And this wonderful artist here, Megan Slankard, what she does for a living is she plays live music, and that's where the majority of, if not all of her income comes from. So back in February, she was playing a show in Nashville, Tennessee, and that was the last one she's played since this weekend. So, and then myself as a concert promoter, putting on shows up at Hot Monk and Marin, house concerts, things all over the city. Me as well has been ceased because we cannot do any live shows. So. Income's been tight, and you know, and the psyche has been pretty psych. And as you guys know, you know, a Zoom or a Facebook show is not quite the same as even just this actually being there. So this weekend has been a really, really big uplifting thing to be able to introduce an artist. I get to undo cables and turn the sound up and down and bring lights. It's just been amazing, and this is our 8th one we've done this weekend. So. Megan is probably tired.
I'm just getting warmed
it's
up.
It's like we've been on tour. We've been in Piedmont, Oakland, Berkeley, San Bruno, Woodside, and this is our first San Francisco one. And so it's just been really, really wonderful. So thank you guys so much for making that happen, and thank you guys all for being here.
Yes, thank
to
you
support
so much.
Because seeing you guys here is really, really important. A couple things real quick. Thank you guys for wearing your masks during the performances, because during the show she won't be masked, and we want to always protect our artists. It's really, really important. And we've got my good friend Dan back here. He's going to be taking some video and stuff because we think this might be the mini future until things do get back to normal. And so he's going to make me like this little commercial of everyone having fun. So making sure people have their masks on looks good for the safety.
Do we get to approve any?
And then also, yeah, totally. And also, obviously, if you're eating or drinking, you can take your mask off to do that for the moment. So there's no worries there. One thing we've learned. So the connection from the artist to the fan is really different when everyone's wearing a mask. So Megan will say a joke, and I will be out in the audience, and people are laughing, but she can't hear it or see anything. So she's just like...
Are you asking them to sympathy laugh for me?
I have an applause. An applause meter. Like
So if you're having a good time, aside from smiling on your mask and squinching your eyes, you know, move around a little bit and don't feel, you know, feel free to applaud when you hear a note that you like, because we just can't, the woos don't come across quite as
can you come
used
or
to the same time.
Also, wait, feel free to also show your disapproval,
you gotta
too.
Come in the side. You know, come down the breezeway.
Scowling.
Yes.
Come down
or
the breezeway.
Keep it under the mask.
She's playing right on the outside the door, so you can't get fire.
So I was grateful for her to be
door,
here. Also, Megan does have merchandise for sale afterwards. You can talk to her about that. Just try to keep your distance. We have a Venmo and PayPal set up. And we're accepting tips as well because, like, every dollar helps keep us alive and keep us going. So most of the money goes to Megan for the tips, but it's also I do get the benefits of it too. So you're supporting an independent promoter and an independent singer-songwriter, and all of our merch, of course, goes right to her. So be sure to grab a CD if you have CD players still, and tote bags. Everyone needs a tote bag. So anyways, we're really excited and slightly delusional because it's been this fourth one today and eighth one
of the
series.
Just delusional enough.
Yeah. But we're getting back in the swing of it. So again, thank you guys for having us, and thank you guys all for being here. And without further ado, I'm so excited to. It's how cool is it to bring this awesome artist to your backyard for these wonderful people? What a cool thing! So,
thank you.
I'm so excited to see people in 3D. It's so nice. I like 3D people. People who are not in a tiny little screen in my phone. Hi. I can hold up my phone and just pretend you're, I'll take a picture and just pretend you're there. It is so great to see you. Thank you so, so much for letting me come over and make noise in your yard. Appreciate it. And this is so cool. It feels like you set this up for music, set it up with music in mind. So anyway, thank you so much for spending a little bit of time with me today. I'm going to play, I'm going to kick it off with a song about trying to remember who you are, get away from the news, get away from my phone, you know, get away from everything that's out there and try to pull it a little bit back to me and remember who I am and remember what I like and remember who I love. And it's called Feeling Like Me.
Feeling.
missing playing, but I've been missing going out and seeing my friends play, and I've been missing going to venues and, you know, smelling the spilled beer, and that's all of those things are part of this big magical thing. And so I'm just so grateful that we can reimagine that right now. And this, humans are so inventive. We invented things like, you know, venues and beer and tickets, and it's so neat that we can see that thing and reimagine in a completely different way and just come hang out in a backyard, in a beautiful backyard with beautiful people. So thank you for letting me be a part of this. Sparkly lights. It's like nothing has changed. So I'm going to sing a little song. I've been doing a lot of, I've been dreaming a lot more for some reason, and I don't know why. I don't know, maybe there's just more space, less traveling, more space for dreams. But I've been dreaming a lot of music, and it's really interesting to just like wake up with a melody in your head. And sometimes that melody is like a Billy Joel song, but sometimes it's something that's yours, and sometimes it comes with lyrics, and that's so fun because it's like, where did it come from? You were asleep. And I'll write it down. Sometimes when you wake up, that's my favorite thing to do. When I wake up, I go and look at my dream song that I wrote down in the middle of the night. And sometimes it's just terrible. You know, you're like, what is this? Is this even music? There are some times that I'll listen to a voice recording that I'll have done to myself. Like, I can't forget this melody. I'll have just woken up. It's like 4 a.m. I just gotta write it down really fast. And it sounds like just me blabbering, definitely still asleep, not even a melody, almost just whispering. But sometimes it comes out in something that's actually a song. And so this next song was one of those songs. It's called You Got This, and it came from a dream. And it was actually, the dream started with this thing where you, anxiety dream, have you ever done that? Where you're like worried about, you know what I'm talking about. You're worried about things, you know, that you will do or that you have done. You know, why did I say that thing in high school, or you know, politics or whatever, you know, did I remember to buy eggs? And, I forgot to mow my lawn. And usually it doesn't matter and you should be sleeping. The whole song came out of this, me telling myself, it's okay, Megan, you got this. And so this is what I wrote. All the demons in your head, trying to get you to go back to bed. What you're chasing dreams is they'll never catch. Sometimes it feels like it's going to get away. Sometimes I feel muscles ache, and you wish you just had a break. Floor is creaking, groaning under all the weight. Sometimes it feels like it's gonna lose a leg. Maybe it is what you need to lean into that leap of faith. Come on, let's go. Oh, let's go. Come on, let's go. Every time you turn on the news, you feel the tension of the news. It's like we're creaking through the nut bolts and screws. Sometimes it feels like it's all gonna break. Oh, baby, won't you let it rain? You don't know nobody anything. You know the saints somewhere instead of sins. Sometimes it feels like it's gonna lose the way. Maybe it is what you need to lean into the leap of faith. Come on, let's go. Got this. can't see what's off the edge. There are not too many things I understand, but I feel like it's gonna be okay. Maybe it is what you need to lean into the leap of faith. Come on, let's go. I don't know if that worked or not. Did that do anything? Apparently it's very sensitive. That's better? Alright, let's do it again. I'm just kidding.
Sounds great to me.
Yay! Time for a little agua.
Mm. Nice to see the face, the whole face. Yeah.
I know I miss people so much. I've been talking a lot to my plants. They don't respond.
No.
I've given them all names. Are they staying alive though?
They're still alive. It's kind of a win for me. Usually I kill them because I go on tour, but now I just look at them a lot and they're pretty. I've given them all names, and you know, it's been a journey. It's been an adventure. When you're used to being on the road like 150 to 250 dates a year, it's so weird being home. You're like, oh, I pay rent for a reason, I guess. That's all right. I forgot about this. I've organized my sock drawer, my refrigerator. Everything is by like color and texture. It's awesome. The mustard has to go right next to the horseradish. Wow, I've been alone too long. Anyway, here's another song. I overshare. I just recorded this brand new version, acoustic version, a live version of this song the other day for this really cool thing that our friends from the Family Crest are doing called Playlist for Progress. It's really cool. So what they're doing is they have this website they built that has tons of different artists on it, like people from Goodnight Texas and King Dream and all these wonderful Bay Area artists and beyond. And you can get exclusive material if you go to the website and you make a donation to Act Blue, and it goes to all these great causes for the environment and for voters' rights and things like that. So, and then in return, we as musicians are just sending some fun exclusive material your way. And so I did a version of this song for that. And I had always wanted to play like an acoustic solo version of it and never figured out how until now. And this is the single off my latest record, Earning a Machinery, and it's called Bones Live Forever. There were times I was alone, dangerous goes the boy. Seeds the thing in my soul, growing weeds with all my questions, like the bones live forever. Can you knock out the wind before it goes on and chatters? Just roll past in the river where the fibers get thin when they're soaking in the water. Home again, didn't take a lifetime. I said there's a way much more often. It keeps me always looking forward. Scars in a could I find out with the mentions and paper next time you write a letter? Go ahead, seal it, address it to the water.
heaven can go straight to hell. Not a word would matter to me. To nurse it still and to find what the other can go is through the changes to the weather. There's a pattern in the older river. I found out in the chicken in the water. Your birthday? Maybe.
It's tomorrow.
That's pretty close. Happy almost birthday! That's so cool! Yeah, I love a good birthday party. Well, hopefully, I mean, are you gonna make her a cake?
Yes.
Okay, good. What kind is it? Should I come back tomorrow? Or?
Like chocolate? Yep.
Yeah, I'll definitely be here. I'll definitely be here. But I also heard you like, I think I'm going to play a song. I think you might like this. You gave me a couple suggestions of songs, and I love this song. So if you like this song, then yay. If you hate it, then I'm sorry. This is one of my favorite songs. I learned this a long time ago when I was a kid and just trying to figure out how to finger pick. And this song is so special to me, and it sort of stuck with me through all these years. It's such a beautiful song. So, I took my love and I took it down. Climbed the mountain and I turned around. And I saw my reflection in the snow-covered hills that a landslide brought me down. Mirror in the sky, what is love? Can the child within my heart rise above? Can I sail through the changing ocean tides can handle the seasons of my life. Well, I've been afraid of changing, 'cause I build my life around you. Well, time makes it bolder, even children get older, and I'm getting older too. Oh, I'm getting older too. And I've been afraid of changing, 'cause I build my life around you. And time makes it bolder, even children get older, and I'm getting older too. Ooh, I'm getting older too. Take my love, take it down. Climb the mountain and turn around. And I saw my reflection in the snow-covered hills, and a landslide brought me down.
He's like, I'm calling the cops.
How cute. I love him.
He's adorable. He's like, he's been just mesmerized by
him. Is this loud enough? Is this loud enough? I just want to make sure it's loud enough. Okay, perfect.
Get a hoop?
He'd have to go to TS.
It's the only day we've had to go back.
I know.
Like
I don't know if that's too loud.
All right. Now I'm going to sing you a song. Hey, Dan. Are you scooching over here?
Yeah. Can I sit in?
Please do.
He's going to play the percussion.
I'm sorry for that.
Don't ever apologize for it.
Mouth percussion through a mask.
All right. This is a tune that will be on my new EP that was supposed to be out, but we had a little delay because our CD release tour, our album release tour has was canceled. The whole year was canceled, which is really interesting. It was really, this year has been really interesting. I both Casey and I, as I suppose probably a lots of artists, sort of held on really tightly to the dates we had booked out further. And as I watched each tour cancel, you know, or we determined that they should all be canceled, it was sort of one of those things. It was like, it was out of this world, actually. It was like, okay, well, I guess we're going to cancel the one that's happening in May, but we'll hold on to the one that's happening in July for a little bit longer, for a couple more weeks, just to make ourselves feel better. But we know that we're eventually going to cancel all of these. And so we had a big year planned. This year, we were opening for Billy Ray Cyrus, out of all people, at Stern Grove. And I've always wanted to play Stern Grove, and I was so excited about that. And I had another Giants National Anthem booked, and we were playing this great festival, and we were doing the 150th year of the Golden Gate Park. We were doing that. And, you know, and it's not just us. It's like, it is sad that I didn't get to play, but also all of these people who put on these festivals and who worked tirelessly for probably the entire year to make this happen. And just how sad it must be to be like, well, we're not going to do it this year. And so it wasn't just the artists, but it was the people who worked in booking and marketing and all of the little details and moving the sound equipment and the doing the sound and all that. And the promoters, not to forget the promoters. The Casey Turner Presents is peoples of the festivals. Like, it has been really interesting just to see like everybody try to figure it out. And so it's been really nice to like be here today and just be a part of this new way to enjoy live music. So I'm just really grateful and happy about it. So thank you very much. And with that said, I'm gonna sing you a new song that's gonna be on the new EP, and it's my Belligerent Rock EP that I'm really looking forward to sharing with you at some point. And this is a reimagined acoustic version of a song called California.
You're so funny, I can hear you all the way clear across the country. Don't care that you're behaving, you're your mother's favorite baby. Your father don't know quite what to do with you, boy. Did you get what you wanted? Did you get what you wanted? Put a ring on a finger, might give you a daughter. We'll fix all of the problems you've had since you were in college. You haven't figured out what to do with them yet. It's the right thing. Listen to your heart sing. Listen to the feeling. Listen to it beating. It's pleading. Listen to the pain. Listen to what your mama say. You do what you wanna and you take what you gotta. But you better leave me. You better leave me with California. California. You better leave me. You better leave me with California. Oh, California. You're so stupid, I think you're so stupid. Did you think that the whole world's gonna bring you to your ruin? You're dressed in disguises, but there should be no surprises. There always come a time you got to deal with it. Put everything you gave me in a cardboard box. Drive it to the corner of the neighborhood thrift shop. If it's from you, I don't want it. But some lucky sucker coming in this week will find some really good stuff. It's the right thing. Listen to your heart sing. Listen to the feeling. Listen to it beating. It's pleading. Listen to me soar. I'm not afraid of you anymore. And you do what you wanna. You take what you gotta. But you better. Listen to me speeding, it's free. Listen, not I'm sure, not listening to you anymore. You do what you want, you take what you gotta, but you better leave me. You better leave me with California. Ah, California. Oh, better leave me. You better leave me with California. Ah, California.
Your neighbors too. Patient.
Hopefully they're all okay.
Yeah. Just give us a heads up if you're not. You're doing great. Yeah, thank you.
Are you sneaking by?
Stay.
You're staying.
Is that okay?
It's totally okay. Are you interpretive dancing behind me? He's like miming. Are you miming? Yeah. You're like trying to spell out California or show the. You're so funny. You're so funny. Yeah, hopefully there's a little bit of that going on behind me. I'm going to sing a little song from, so I'm doing this thing called Patreon, which I love and is so exciting. And what it is like a subscription service to me, I guess, my creativity. It's like the Netflix of Megan Slankard. And it's so much fun because what I get to do is I get to write a brand new song every month and share it with you. And I try to challenge myself to write a song with different tricks and instruments and you know, things that I've learned in the studio and different genres. Like sometimes it's a punk song or an acoustic song, a country song, an acapella song, weird indie music. It's been so much fun and it's been a great way to grow. And it also has pretty much been the only thing that has kept me afloat the last several months, because I have not, again, like Casey was saying, I have not been able to play any shows, and because of a small but hilarious error, I have not been able to get any unemployment, and so it has been sort of a challenge. And I've been really grateful to the people who have been giving me work, studio work and things like that, and grateful, you know, to my family and friends who helped anytime that I've needed a little boost. But yeah, Patreon has been amazing, not only for that, but the fact that I've built this community there where I get to hang out with people and just talk about music and, you know, where everything is sort of like behind the scenes, where I get to show people new creations and it's not out there on the internet for everybody to see and judge. It's like a small group of people who are going to be like, well, what do you think of this? And people are like, that's great. This part's confusing to me, or this is fun. I like when you use that. And it's so helpful to me as a songwriter to be able to have that. And so one of the concepts that I was exploring on Patreon was this concept of love and trying to figure out what love is, and through songwriting and, you know, different ways you could talk about it. And love is the classic thing to write about, right? And I was trying to come up with another metaphor to, you know, like the new classic metaphor. And so I think I did. I think love is like a microwavable burrito. And maybe you disagree with me in this new metaphor, but hear me out. Okay. It's the only thing, like, you get it, you're hungry, you know, it's full of nutrients and vitamins. Well, I know this, we'll roll with it though. You're really excited about it. It was cheap. You got it at Trader Joe's. We all know this. We're rolling with it. It's going to nourish you. It feels good. And you pop it in the microwave and you're waiting and anticipating and you're so excited. And then it's the only thing, this is like, just like love to me. You pull it out and it's molten lava on the outside, yet still frozen in the middle. It's a little confusing, yet you still eat it. So, it, with all of its flaws and, you know, maybe it doesn't have all the vitamins I was talking about, but you still eat it. You still like it. Let's be honest. You still like it. And down the hatch it goes. So I wanted to write a song about that. Thankfully, I was able to tear myself away from the frozen burrito metaphor. But maybe that's next Patreon song. For now, this is a little song called How Can You Tell? And it goes like this.
you tell you have a broken heart? Do you take it apart? Do you root around inside? Are the wires really bent and the gears too tight? How can you tell your heart's broken? Is it cold to the touch? Is it raw in the center? Is it only when it ends that you notice it's better? Well, it hurts like hell, but it's really hard to tell between working and broken some days. I'd like to know before it ceases, between a heart and loving and pieces, to me they both feel the same. How can you tell you have a broken heart? Does it sing too sharp? Can it not find the beat? Are the strings out of tune? And the notes too hard to reach? It hurts like hell, but it's really hard to tell between working and broken some days. I would like to know before it ceases, between a heart and loving and pieces of me, they both feel the afraid at the ends. Oh, it don't really matter if you don't use it again. Ooh, it hurts like hell, but it's really hard to tell between working and broken some days. I would like to know before it ceases, between a heart and love and pieces of me, they both feel the same. To me, they both feel the same. To me, they both feel the same.
Song in the history of humanity inspired by Trader Joe's microwavable burritos. This concert is sponsored by Trader Joe's microwavable burritos, now in two flavors. Thank you, Dan. Yeah. For some reason, I just want microwavable burritos. They're the kind of bad that's so good. You know what I'm talking about. Yeah. Oh. Are you guys going to do this all the time now? Have concerts in the backyard?
Sure.
I think it's the best
idea.
Sounds
like a good idea.
When are you coming back?
Oh, tomorrow.
Coming back tomorrow for cake. Yeah,
I heard there was cake and yeah.
I'll be here. I was going to sing what song? Oh yeah. I'm gonna sing this song from, if I can get this right.
No, I'll sing this song instead. I can't ever make up my mind. All right, this is a song from my album Running on Machinery. It's a album picture with the creepy rabbit running on it. I like that music and albums. I like making albums because the whole thing can be a piece of art. You know, you can have album cover and liner notes and all these fun little things. Which is funny because we're totally getting away from that and we're all just about singles on Spotify. And it honestly, it's much easier and there's a lot less waste. But if you still like albums, I have some. Or if you like coasters, I have some of those. There's a CD inside of them. I should not have told the walls what you did. I didn't hesitate a second before it slipped my lips. And my heart had melted from my sleeve. When I knew that you were done. The ending sort of thing, because you never know. What is Casey doing? Oh! Hi, people of the internet. Casey was just waving at himself. And now he hates me more. Laura, I'm going to sing you another song. I'm just going to keep singling you out because you're special. I love this song too. This reminds me of the Bay Area a lot. It reminds me of the Bay, and I don't know, I love it. Reminds me of floating and flying. It's a Van Morrison song.
Oh, yeah.
We were born before the wind, also younger than the sun. Yeah, the bonnet bubbles won as it sailed off into the mystic. Hark, now hear the sailors cry. Smell the sea and feel the sky. Let your soul and let your spirit fly as you sail up into the mystic. When the foghorn blows, I will be coming home. When the foghorn whistle blows, I want to hear it. And I don't want to feel it. And I want to rock your gypsy soul. Ooh, just like way back in the days of old. Oh, oh, as we sailed up into the mystic. I'm gonna take a quick tuning break and tune my old guitar. It's been having a lot of fun, I think, itself, being outside. My apartment is like a southern facing, there's one big window in that faces south, and so the sun sort of starts out of the way and then becomes sunny in my house, and then it goes out of the way, and that's the only light, so my apartment's like this very dark cave. And that's where me and my guitar play, in the window, in our cave, writing our weird songs. It's really fun, but it is kind of nice to see humans and daylight, and trees, lovely. Today we played our first show of the tour today was, we played with some there were some chickens, and they definitely sang along. I think one of them laid an egg during the set, so she was like, bop, 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 bop. And it was really hard to sing, like, weird folk songs with that going on in the background. I really enjoyed it, though. I think they were embarrassed about their chickens. Yeah, I felt really bad because they're...
I know it's for dinner tonight.
You what?
I know it's for dinner tonight at their house.
Oh. Eggs.
Wrong. No, they had the chickens that wear pants. You know what chickens I'm talking about? Have you ever seen the chickens that look like they're wearing pants? Oh, it's the best. They have like fur on their legs. It's hilarious. I love them so much. I don't think I've loved anything as much as I love chickens who look like they're wearing pants. That and the sound of dogs eating carrots and just... You know what I'm talking about. That's the best sound in the world right there. See, when you break life down into these simple little things, it's totally doable. I know it's an election year, but let's just listen to dogs eating carrots and look up pictures of chickens wearing pants, and we're all good.
And now I'm going to tune on that note. How are we doing on time? Okay.
You're trying to wait for me.
How did this day go by so fast?
It's been the most fun show.
This has definitely been the most fun show.
Yes!
Hands down, the winner.
The last one's always the best.
It is always the best.
Is always the best.
Yours, if yours was first, it would have been the best, though. So let's just be honest. Thank you so much. I'm so grateful. Thank you. That makes me so happy.
Yes.
Yes, I love
it. I love this backyard.
All right, well, I got a couple more songs for you. Thank you so very much for having me. I am really grateful to be here and to spend this time with you in this short existence we have on this planet. I really appreciate you. And yeah, cheers to best backyard hangout ever. And biggest happy birthday to you, Laura. I'm excited for you and your cake. And here is
where did it go? Here.
I'm going to sing a Simon and Garfunkel tune for you. I feel like this is my favorite story pushed into a little 3 minutes that I've ever heard. It's all takes place on a bus, and I think it's just so beautiful. And yeah, I think it's my favorite, one of my favorite songs that's ever been written. And I think I'll just give it. Because it's pretty and it should have a pretty tuning. Here we go. Okay. Let us be lovers and marry our fortunes together. I've got some real estate here in my bag. So we bought a pack of cigarettes, Mrs. Wagner's pies, and walked off to look for a man's car. Kathy, I said, as we boarded the Greyhound in Pittsburgh,
Michigan seems like a dream to me now. It took me 4 days each hike from Saginaw. I've come to look for America. Laughing on the bus, playing games with the faces. She said the man in the gabardine suit was a spy. I said, be careful, his bow tie is really a camera. Toss me a cigarette, I think there's one in my raincoat. We smoked the last one an hour ago. So I looked at the scenery. She read her magazines and the moon rose over an open field. Kathy, I'm lost, I said, though I knew she was sleeping.
Song, but before I do, I think we should all sing Happy Birthday with Laura. So we can do it. We can do it to a guitar. So we... Don't leave.
Please come down there with them.
Yay, birthday girl! All right. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Laura. Happy birthday to you. And many more. Yeah, you guys are dynamite singers. What am I doing up here? We're gonna take turns after this. Surprise! Yeah. Anyway, thank you. It's been such a joy. Thank you so much for having me. You guys, you are all just lovely. And if it weren't COVID times, I'd hug you all. But since it is, just know that I am mentally hugging you in a very loving way. And I am so grateful to be here with you, so thank you. And I'll be back tomorrow for some cake. Here's a song called The Best in Me. Oh, and a huge thank you to Casey Turner for doing sound and putting this whole thing together. Very, very appreciative. And if anybody else wants a concert, you've got a few... I hiccuped. A few more artists. Look here, you guys. sorry, Jade Plant. I'm sorry that happens to you. But you have a few like artists that other artists that you are doing this with. I think everybody sold out, right? Except for
a couple for Steve Holtz.
Jeez. Well, exciting. Anyway, thank you, Casey. And hey, Dan, thank you so much for coming and doing a little bit of filming.
Yeah.
You're the best. Yeah. Anyway, thank you all. I appreciate it. Thanks, Kevin. Thanks, Laura. I really appreciate it. Okay, here's a song called Best in Me. You do a party, and I do a punch. Sit in a cold bowl, but I bought a warm gun. You wanna have a family, but I wanna have a good time. You're looking to the future, I'm just looking for another glass of wine. Hey, you see the best in me. When all I see is just a chance to get up and leave. You're the best in me. Oh, the best to confess ain't as good as you could be. And you're picking up my pieces, putting down a number two, man. Got a lot of things on your mind. Some of them might be my demons. You wanna have a conscience. Sometimes you wish you never met me. You don't know why I stay here. I don't know why you haven't left me. And how you see the best in me. When all I say is just a chance. Part of me in quite a while. Oh, and I don't know. When you're picking up my pieces, I'm putting down enough for two, man. You got a lot of things in your mind. Some of them might be my demons. When hell you see the best in me. When all I see is just a chance to get up and leave. Ooh, you're the best in me. Oh, oh, the best of the best ain't as good as it could be. Exactly what I was thinking. Which should I do the one that was at the where you gave me the thumbs up when at the last yes. one? I don't have to. Unless
cover
you...
or original?
Original.
Okay. Okay.
Any.
Yeah. Well, thank you, everybody. I really appreciate it.
Yay!
This is really doing us a world of good because this, again, like Casey said, it's my first set of shows since February 26th. And I'm used to being on the road 150 to 250 dates a year, and so it's been really strange being at home. But lovely, and it's lovely to see you all and be here, and I'll just play this one last song. And if you have any questions or if you are interested in signing up for Patreon, you can get all 70 of the releases that I've released there, all for, you know, you can download them all right now. All right, so here's the song. It's called The Token of the Wreckage. And it's a little out of tune. This is the San Francisco my guitar knows and loves. Little cold. That's a wrap. Was it half bad? Keep me off to bed. I think I'm dying slightly after a day like that. Oh, it starts out dark. Sun started to bark. Man, stab like a fork and nothing much forgiving about the way that we are. Hello, I've got a heart hanging around by the door, and I've got grace hanging in the mirror, and I've got you, a little souvenir. A token of the wreckage. Ah. We don't argue, we're tired of that too. Spoons clicking or soup, we're aware it's a meal. Probably means that we're doomed. You say nothing to me, nor turn up again how to speak. In a mission of defeat, fair game for all. All in a piece of our dreams. And I've got a heart hanging round by the door. I've got grace hanging in. And I've got you, a little souvenir, a token of the wreckage. You're quite the quandary. Oh, and I keep thinking maybe that's my problem. Just stop thinking. Jump on a step on a trip on a stomp on them. Foolish to believe that I can't be foolish. Oh, my head spins, I won't stop. I wish I would just shut up. Please stop, please stop. Like I said, I got a hurt. The door. I got grace hanging in the mirror, and I've got you, a little souvenir, a token of the wreckage. Thank you so much. Thank you. I'm so grateful to be here.
Megan Slater, give us a hand. Thank you guys again. guys so much for listening and keeping each other safe during that. This is, I think, maybe not our future, but maybe our immediate future. And I'm thinking after this month, we might be doing this in the spring. So please stay tuned. And thank you guys so much for being here. Really do appreciate it. Yeah. She does have some merchandise here if you'd like to purchase it. And your tips are so appreciative, and it will support us through this. And but just most importantly, we're just really happy to be able to share this experience with everyone. So.
Right? Thanks for letting me make noise.
She can play in your backyard too.
And we actually aren't kidding. This was one of the most fun.
This was so much fun.
And so thank you guys so much for being so sweet. And just give it one more time for Megan Slicer. Woo! Thank you guys.